Welcome to How to DualBoot Windows and Chrome OS on the Same Computer. Besides the Windows operating system, you will have interesting experiences on Chrome OS. On Chrome OS you can install apps with Google Play. Let's get started. This is my Windows computer and I will also install Chrome OS. First, I create a new partition. I recommend that you create a partition that is at least 50 gigabytes in size. Depending on the number of applications that will be installed on Chrome OS, the size of this partition will be determined. This is the partition I just created. I will install Chrome OS on this partition. Next, I installed Windows subsystem for Linux. I create a Linux environment on Windows to create Chrome OS image files. Make sure your computer has virtualization enabled before installing Windows subsystem for Linux. You access the BIOS to enable virtualization. After completing the installation of Windows subsystem for Linux, you are required to restart your computer to apply the changes. If you use an ASUS motherboard, here's how to enable virtualization. Once completed booting, a new Ubuntu window opens automatically. Here you are asked to create a new administrative account on Ubuntu. You use the administrator account to install the application or log in next time. Next, you download the Chrome OS image file to your computer. There are many image files for different devices. So which one is the image file for your computer? You need to know what processor your computer uses. And this is the processor on my computer. It is not the same on different computers. I use 9th generation Intel processor. Each generation of processor has a different code name. You use the code name to search for the appropriate Chrome OS image file. I downloaded the latest version for my computer. However, this image file cannot be booted on your computer. And you need to add a boot file to this image file. You download the file above to boot Chrome OS on your computer. These are two folders after being downloaded and extracted. I created a new folder called Chrome OS. I then copied all the newly downloaded files to the newly created folder. The default name of the image file is long and difficult to remember, so I renamed the file. This file name is used in the command used in the following steps, so you name the file the same as they do. I delete unused folders to avoid confusion. After getting the folder with the necessary files, open the Ubuntu window and use the following commands. Before installing or doing anything, you should update Ubuntu. After updating, install the following packages to support creating bootable image files. To create a ChromeOS image file, browse to the folder just created in the previous step. You replace the path to your directory. Please note to change the command to suit the Linux environment. Because the way to browse to a folder in Linux is different from Windows, I browsed to the target folder and here are the files in that folder. Next, I created a bootable ChromeOS image file. Here is the command to create that image file. You change the letter of the ChromeOS partition. In this case, it is the letter D. Next, you set the file size. You make sure the file size is smaller than the ChromeOS partition size. Now the image file starts to be created. When you access the ChromeOS partition, you will see an image file appear. Here you read instructions to create an image file for DualBoot. Enter DualBoot as instructed. In addition to the image file, there is also a text file. It is used to configure DualBoot. Detailed instructions on DualBoot configuration. Your Windows computer ensures the above things to ensure successful booting of ChromeOS. You disable BitLocker, disable Fast Startup, disable Hibernation. As instructed above, I downloaded the DualBoot configuration software. You download and install the software as above. Here you click Manage Boot menu. You create a new entry as instructed. Next, copy the code generated in the previous step and paste it into the boot configuration file. Then you save the changes. So I have completed the DualBoot configuration. Now you just need to restart your computer to check the results. I accessed the BIOS to ensure the computer was DualBoot. If you see this, it means you have successfully configured DualBoot. Here I choose to boot ChromeOS. I have completed dual booting ChromeOS in Windows. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You log into your Google account for the first time logging in. You use your Google password the next time you log in. Good luck.